In this video, I will show you 5 things you didn't know you could do with GitHub Copilot. And then there is a bonus. So in GitHub Copilot, you can give prompt in any language. There is no language barrier. Let me show you. So I'm going to give a prompt to build a snake exchange, Nokia snake game. But I will use Hindi language to give the prompt. So I will say, ek Nokia mobile jaisa snake wala game banao. Okay. So our game is working. You can fetch any API directly from your Copilot, and based on your response, you can build your UI or you can make changes in your application. So I will show you by fetching this REST countries API. Here just paste the API and then use hash. Hash will select the fetch tool. Hash fetch, fetch this API, and based on response, show all countries in a beautiful grid. And it will ask to fetch this web page. So click continue. After fetching the API, it say I see your HTML file is currently empty. So it will create all the data grid, and based on that, it will show the country in a beautiful grid. I think it is ready now. Let's run the server and see how it will look. Awesome, loading countries, and beautiful. We have this awesome grid of countries here. GitHub Copilot comes with many inbuilt tools that we can utilize to become even more productive. To use a tool, what you have to do, just enter hash and select the tool name. Like in our last point, we used the fetch tool to fetch the API response or any web pages. Similarly, you can select any of the tool. There are multiple tools, like for seeing all the changes in your code base, for creating and running a task, for finding the test file, finding the problem, searching the result. So let's try this problems tool. What this tool will do, it will try to find all the problems in our file. So in this case, we have one problem. So let's see if it will detect and fix it. So just select the tool and send it. Okay, so it detected the problem that there is no catch block inside our fetch country try block. So let's see if it changed. Yes. So it detected there were no catch block, so it added the catch block in our code, and now there is no problem in our code. If you want to add some other external tools, then you can click here on this little icon and you will see here add more tools option. So once you will click on it, you have two options. Either you can install a MCP server if you want a dedicated video on using the MCP server on VS Code GitHub Copilot, then comment down. I will create a dedicated video about the MCP server. We can use this install extension option to install some other tools, like here, whatever are available. So here my favorite tool is web search for Copilot. You can create and save a prompt template to speed up your work, to not repeat same prompt again and again. I have this file, unit test prompt.md. So this prompt is for writing unit test cases for a selected component. So this is the reusable prompt, and if you are not using a reusable prompt file, then we have to write this long prompt again and again each time we want to generate a unit test case. For that purpose, you can create a prompt file. How? By default, it's inside .github folder. Create a new folder called prompts, and inside prompts folder you can create markdown files xyg_prompt.md. Okay, so how to use these prompts? Simply click on this tool icon or add context option, and here you will see this prompt option. Click on it and you can see it detected all my available prompts. So just select it, and now if I will go inside a component, like let's say this create room component, what I have to do, I don't have to write any prompt to just generate unit test cases for this file covering all the scenarios, like interactions, or I just have to click send and it will use the prompt that I have here inside my prompts unit test prompt.md file, and based on that it will generate the unit test cases for my component. How you can do that? Just control R command comma, here search for instructions. So let's click on here, edit, and then let me use just one instruction here. Don't use any comment. Don't use any comment in the code. So sounds like a good instruction. Let's try it. Now I will say create a new component for showcase purpose. And now what it will do, it will not write any comment in the newly generated code. Why? Because by default now we have added in the code generation instruction that do not use any comment in the code. So this explicit prompt will go with all our prompts, so we don't have to write it each time explicitly. Okay, so it started creating this showcase page, and as you can see, usually it adds lots of comment, but in this case there's not even a single comment in this code. So that's how you can utilize the custom instructions. Here is the bonus. You can enable auto approve that will automatically approve all the pop-ups that it asks your confirmation. Like let's say if I will say run this application. See, this is without auto approve. So here I have to click continue to start this application to run the server. Now the server has started, but with auto approve mode it will not even ask from you. So let's clear it and let's turn on the auto approve mode. So how you can turn on the auto approve mode? Go to settings and search for auto approve, and here inside the check section you have this auto approve section. So click on it. Let's see the auto approve feature. Run this app. This time it should automatically apply those commands in the terminal without asking from me. So see, now it automatically applied and this application is now running. It didn't even ask from me to continue. If you wanted to do pure vibe coding, just give a prompt and go somewhere else, it should just do everything automatically, then you can use this awesome auto approve feature.